Okay, so I know I told you the next biker film we were going to do is the sequel to Easy Rider, but I was wrong. It's not a sequel, it's a prequel, and it is notably recognized as being a terrible film.
You didn't tell me that before we were going to watch this.
So, and welcome. My wife is here with us today.
I was unaware of being a giant
fan. Leonard Maltin, who, do you remember Leonard Maltin? He's from Entertainment Tonight. He was a movie critic.
Oh, right.
And he says the film is a bomb, and he described the film as a staggeringly bad attempt to cash in on the iconic original, and that it is poor on all accounts. It is compared to The Room. If you don't know what The Room is, it is considered the worst movie ever made. So, I expect this to be kind of comedic for us.
Well, the question is it so bad it's good?
I don't know, because I've never watched it. It was straight to DVD, and the guy, there's actually three of these. The guy that bought the rights to Easy Rider wrote this. He also wrote a third one, which hasn't been made. The third one, let me see if I can see what it's called here. The third one is called Easy Rider, The Search Continues. Now, I don't know if that's in between the two. Maybe they're like Star Wars. They made it all in the wrong order. I don't know if it's supposed to be after. I have no idea. That, as far as I know, hasn't been made. But this guy that wrote this one, his name's Phil Pitzer, and he was absolutely obsessed with it and thinks that he did a really great job. So,
his parents love him.
Again, I haven't seen it. Let's go through it together, shall we?
Are there any celebrities in it?
Not that I'm aware of.
It's a good sign.
But I think the guy that wrote it is in it.
Of course.
He devoted 6 years to developing this motion picture exclusively to push the Easy Rider franchise forward. So, let's see what we got.
May God have mercy on our souls.
On today's Graybeard Biker. Alright, so I was wrong about one thing. Phil Pitzer is not in it. Mm-hmm. He wrote it. He produced it. He is not in it. The people that are in it are no one you know. So, I'm not even going to bother with their names. This was released in February of 2012 at Bike Fest Tampa. That's an interesting little piece of trivia.
But it was filmed at the festival?
No. It was released at the festival.
Oh, they had like a little premiere.
At the rally, probably. Huh. Right. I actually didn't know that Tampa had a bike fest. I know St. Pete does.
It could be the same thing.
Now, as always, we have our snacks here, and we're raring to go. So let's jump into this thing. Hopefully, you know, I've given you a little bit of trivia so far, but if I find some more, I'll let you know. All right.
Bring on the trash.
My name is Morgan Williams. I had a brother, Wyatt. He had this nickname, Captain America. Day after Mardi Gras, 1969, Wyatt and his best friend, Billy, were riding their bikes, heading for Florida. The sky was crystal blue, just like 9/11. Wyatt died that day, a victim of hatred and prejudice at the hands of those whose greatest fear is freedom, whether in the form of a nation or a single individual. Finally making the ride back after 40 years. Time to face the ghost of the past And all because little sister Shane showed up at my Imla about to coast to Mexico.
I guess I missed something, too. How's your friend?
Not so well tonight.
Well, then I guess I don't have to ask what's in here. Jesus, Morgan. How much is in here?
Not enough. Shane, it's only pot. Only thing I've ever done. Only thing I'm ever gonna do.
When are you gonna grow up?
Shane was freaked that I was dealing. And to make matters worse,
he thought why I died of drugs.
But I got her straightened out on that.
It's some other family history too.
To use over and over and over again.
Yeah, well, you know, you were too young to remember it. But after Mama died, we were all lost. And Wyatt, he tried to find himself by splitting to L.A., snorting coke, crazy, smoking dope. And Wyatt decided, well, maybe it helped supply the demand. Then he started dealing drugs. First, he was dealing pot for me, but then he wanted to make the big score, cocaine, early retirement. So, I hooked him with a guy down in Ensenada. He did the deal, but of course, he didn't live to enjoy it.
Thank God Daddy doesn't know any of this, because I don't think he could bear to have...
What, two sons like me? Is that what you're going to say? That's what you're going to say, wasn't it?
That's not what I meant.
Well, it is what you meant. And that's okay. Because I got really good at keeping this family's dirty little secrets in check. And only Virgil and me know about this. The thing he wants to see after all this time is my ass.
Why do you two still hate each other after all these years? It's ridiculous.
Because maybe, Shane, hate isn't the opposite of love. It's the frustration of love.
Can't you just make the first move? Let bygones be bygones?
Let me tell you something. He didn't like the way I expressed my freedom back then, and he's not going to look any better now.
Really, we're going to duplicate this, too?
Stashing the cash in the tank. Family tradition.
Did I stay too long in the cold? Did I miss the day he grew?
Jesus Christ, I thought I saw a ghost. I don't know what the hell you're doing here, brother. You better be ready to drink some whiskey, boy.
I love your racing school, man.
I was thinking...
He's got his brother's glasses. He's got his haircut.
Now, which one was his brother?
Peter Farber.
He's not Peter Fonda, though. I'm just going to keep Peter Fonda ingredient. Peter Fondinus. So he was in Wyatt Earp in 94.
The second guy?
The one, not him, but the Wyatt Earp. Yeah. Yeah.
Would you trade all this for more freedom?
His name is Jeff
Baby,
and he's Irish.
Yeah, I'd like to take that trip.
Well, I know what you mean about time, man.
Okay, so once again, the star of this movie is going to be the motorcycle. However, it's not shot that way. It's shot so that the star of the movie is the bad acting. This is worse than the first Star Wars. As far as acting is concerned. Not very good acting.
So, according to IMDb, these are the featured reviews of this movie. One is, while this is a sequel, it's also kind of a prequel. This one said, some people should not be allowed to make movies. A vanity project for a former lawyer. And then this one says, Hopper and Fonda are spinning in their graves, or at least this sent them to their graves. This is not about the motorcycle, it's more of a dramatic biography.
Now, one of the things that I've noticed already, besides the bad acting, is they keep bringing up the previous movie's main character, Wyatt. They keep bringing him up. They must have dropped his name 15 times and the movie's been on 20 minutes. He keeps dropping his brother's name constantly. As if to remind you, hey, you remember Easy Rider? Hey, you remember Easy Rider? Hey, you remember that movie, Easy Rider? Throughout this whole thing. So they keep talking about that. He is literally he's riding his motorcycle, wearing his jacket, wearing his sunglasses. I mean, cut his hair to look like him.
Like, he's supposed to see his brother, though.
Yeah.
He's trying to keep his brother's memory alive, but...
So the premise so far, if you get through all the bad stuff, is that for some reason, 40 years later, the brother, this is Wyatt's brother, Peter Fonda's brother, is riding back to L.A. Where is he? No idea. Where's he from? Don't know. They may have said it, but I don't know. So the idea is he's kind of making the opposite run that Hopper and Fonda did. So he just said that he's doing it, you know, kind of in honor of his brother. And he's got himself a Dennis Hopper to go with him. So far, that part makes sense. There's also a sister we didn't know about. Oh, he also keeps invoking the word freedom every 5 minutes. Oh, the way I express my freedom. So, yeah.
Yeah, he's Captain Obvious. I mean, Captain America, Captain Obvious.
Freedom. Not just the theme, the word. He keeps literally saying things that he thinks are supposed to be cliche that were included in the first movie. Hey, you remember Easy Rider? Hey, you remember Easy Rider? Hey, you remember that movie, Easy Rider? So.
He's a clear fanboy.
Not very good writing. I am very impressed that he bought the rights and made a movie. It's just not a very good movie. So far.
It might get better.
It might. You never know.
It might.
It could happen.
It could happen. It won't.
Daddy! 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 Good morning.
Yeah. What's so good about it?
The other thing about this is Easy Rider was known for being the first film to put existing songs in it. The Steppenwolf songs already existed before they went into the Easy Rider movie. This one recognized none of these songs. They all appear to be made for the film. Now, if they had, you know, possibly found a better soundtrack to go along with it, and because some of the motorcycle scenes are nice. Of course, that's because I love the open road. But it looks nice going through the desert, you know. It looks nice. The music is not, you know, it's not scored the same as Easy Rider was. And being as that's something that really stood out about Hopper's movie, Dennis Hopper is the one that directed Easy Rider. He made that decision to put in existing songs.
That was mine.
I'm assuming that he just didn't have the money. That's another difference. Easy Rider was made with people that were already successful actors. This is like all newbie stuff.
I still think it's that guy wrote it. I'm going to call it.
Well, he wrote it. Yeah. I will tell you this. We've already started this movie, and the camera died, and so now we're having to do it again. So, yeah. So, in reading about this, some people call it a prequel. I've seen 28 minutes of it already. It's not a prequel. Maybe it becomes a prequel later, but right now it is a sequel.
It's like a sequel with a lot of flashbacks.
Yes.
You can attack the war man, but never the warrior.
Hey, Rieger wanted me to come over here and see if you guys needed anything.
Maybe you can tell me where a couple tired old men can score a little reefer.
Oh, reefer. Well, around here we call it pot.
Pot.
Yeah, I can score it, but I don't have it with me.
Well, why don't you just jump on the back of my bike and you can show us where it's at?
Oh, I got a bike.
It's a beauty. Please tell me this bitch is gonna buy you. Hell yeah! That's a Biker Barbie! Look at her boobs out! She's amazing! Fuck yeah! This movie just got interesting. Four blonde bitches on bikes is what I say. She looks amazing. Sometimes it got hot as hell in the desert. And just as cold as hell. Keep on riding.
I got a bike.
I got a helmet.
And it's a beauty.
I got a beauty.
If you wanna.
Thanks for coming.
Well, thanks for asking me.
It's so nice to meet you after all this.
Whoa, hey. Huh. Thought I lost you there. Just take it easy, okay? Your leg's all messed up.
Still there?
Oh, yeah. Pretty nasty gash, though. Some other cuts we need to clean up.
Cool.
You are one lucky son of a bitch. The bike saved your life. Shielded you from the blast.
Thanks, Stonewall.
I'd always wanted to check out the Salton Sea. Greatest ecological disaster in the history of California.
Gotta start taking better care of this planet.
Oh, well, let's kick back.
I will say that this movie's a little bit all over the place. Starts off as a sequel, has a bunch of flashbacks for prequel, and the storyline is actually not bad. I'm interested to know what happens. The acting is not good.
Well, we're seeing a little bit less of the Morgan character, and he's the really bad actor in my
opinion.
Yes. He's also the director. But I think that the lady that plays Shane, she's doing a good job.
Well, it's also the whole flashback thing. While there's a lineage of motorcycle throughout the family history, which is great. But there's not as much focus on the ride as there was in the first one, or even the first half of this one, honestly. But there's, you know, the father, which is Peter Fonda's dad in the movie, had rode a motorcycle in the war, rode a Harley in the war, and got hurt in the war on the motorcycle, and then came back, taught his boys the love of motorcycling, et cetera, et cetera. That part's cool. But the whole freedom ride of the road thing is not as much in the second half of this one anyway.
Yeah, no, the only real motor, like riding scenes are Morgan and West Coast coming, you know, like the cutaways of them traveling. But other than that, the real story is happening in this like ranch house.
Yeah, which is the prequel part.
Yeah. But
But yeah, the cutaways to the flash, like the flashbacks and the war scenes are interesting.
Yeah.
And there's still a love of the bike, the sidecar.
There is.
There's a tie-in always.
Yep.
See this? That's a symbol of the motorcycle club I started. We got it after the kids were born. But it's more than that.
On my medic satchel.
Yes.
Well, that was him.
Thank you, Stonewall.
Yes, sir.
And you all fade away. What country you do? You're forever. Is true now. But you still got that.
We never see him get the bike.
Nope.
It's just like the end of it. Like that was like a Game of Thrones style, oh shit, we have to do an ending thrown together.
Well, Game of Thrones at least, I mean they ended it in some big, awesome tragedy. This one just ended.
It feels like there should have been like one more scene where like you get to meet Virgil.
Right, where Virgil comes, they give the dad the gift.
Everybody's there but Wyatt.
Yeah.
Because it ended up becoming Virgil's movie there halfway through.
Yeah.
Like I'm invested in this Virgil cat, and I don't know. Because he's like, you know, Dad, we never told Dad why you really joined or why you really dodged the war and why he really went. And I mean, not that all needed to come out to his father, but I mean, it's just like we never get to meet Virgil. In fact, we don't even get to see his face after the war because he had the hood on.
So this movie's all over the place. I will say that it's better than I expected it to be.
His bar is really low, y'all.
The acting is bad.
The woman that plays Shane, I think, is good though.
There's two actors
and Wes
that I recognize. Jeff. Whatever his name is that played Hopper's Fahey. Character.
No, Frank Fahey.
And Jeff. Yeah, Jeff something. And then, and I don't know what I recognize him from. And then there was...
all of these are performed the by girls.
Yeah. But it didn't have as much emphasis on writing. It did have an emphasis somewhat on the love of motorcycles and passing them down from generation to generation. That part was interesting. You know, the dad was on Harley during the war, which is how a lot of people got introduced to Harley Davidson, and then passed the love of motorcycles on to his children. Started a club, which we never saw the club. But it was still very interesting. We never saw the club. We saw the symbol for the club.
Yeah.
We didn't even know the name of the club. He started a club. it wasn't well written. There was stuff all over the place. I mean, there must have been, what, four or five different storylines going on, and none of them finished. Not a one of them finished. Mm-hmm. Except for maybe the brother riding across the country, he did that. But
yeah.
That was the most boring part of
that's
the most boring part of the story. You know, we had the Dennis Hopper character, West Coast, don't get me started on that. He had a storyline that literally never began and never ended at all.
He had a pretty wicked cool flashback though.
Virgil had a storyline, didn't end. The dad had a storyline, didn't end. The daughter was evidently rich. We have no idea how or why. She has a son who's joining the military, but we never saw him again after that. Lots of missing pieces in this. But it was interesting. I do enjoy seeing motorcycles on the screen. That's the best thing I have to say about it.
Yeah, I mean, I felt like it was actually better than I was expecting it to be as well.
Yeah.
I mean, it was still terrible, but it was interesting. And the thing that makes this a terrible movie is that you actually do get kind of invested mm-hmm. at some point in the middle and then the latter half. And you're like, okay, all right. You know, you're getting your feet under you. You're like, I'm following it. I'm invested in some of these characters. And so then you're thinking to yourself, this movie isn't that bad. And then it just ends. And you have no resolution to any of the characters that you were invested in. And so that's what pisses me off. And so now you just leave this movie being kind of pissed off and unsatisfied. It's bad sex, everybody.
So, yeah. So, let me know what you thought of this movie in the comments, if you bother to watch it.
If you successfully made it through all 158 minutes or whatever.
You have to excuse the bad acting, which is hard for some people to do.
I've seen worse acting.
There's been a lot of good movies with bad acting. Star Wars, for example. But it made up for it in other ways. The problem is this one just didn't make up for it.
This one was a very anti-war movie.
It was a very pro-military movie.
Mm-hmm. Hate the war, don't hate the warrior.
Yeah, that was the best line of the whole thing. But there was lots
of... No. The best line of the whole thing. Oh, I got a bike. That's the best line.
It had very strong... patriotism things go through it. Love of country was there. Even the guy that was the draft dodger, he still loved his country. He just dodged the... He didn't like the war. But he still had respect for the warrior, which is something America really screwed up with Nam.
I have a question, though, because in the campfire scene, Wes says... Does he know that your brother told you not to go, why he told you not to go to Nam? Or, you know, why not?
Right.
But do we ever, why would he tell him not to go?
Because he got damaged when he was there. Because
he killed a kid?
Yeah. So that wasn't said, I think it was unsaid. But that part makes sense to me. Except I don't know the plausibility of...
And then he said, I guess if I'm correct, he implied that the reason why he... went to war was because of what happened to him and that girl.
Yeah, and he was never going to let it happen to somebody he loved again.
What does that have to do with anything? He left the girl.
He wanted to become tough. Tough enough to take care of himself, so he joined the military.
Oh, okay. So that was his, bad boy boot camp?
Yeah. The problem is she married somebody else while he was gone.
Well, no offense to her, you know, but, like...
She may have dumped him.
It was a bad first date.
Yeah.
Very bad.
So let's see if we can find some more trivia for this thing here. I am curious to know whatever... You have your phone?
I can get it. I can tell you some trivia.
Look up Easy Rider, The Search Continues, and see if anything ever became of that.
I can give you some useless trivia real quick as I'm doing that.
Okay.
The guy that plays West Coast, his name is Jeff Fahey.
Mm-hmm.
He was born and raised in New York. And he was actually a Joffrey School of Ballet ballerina for a very long time. And like he was there on scholarship because he was a ballet dancer and he was also a ballroom dancer. And he was one of 13 children.
Phil Pitzer has devoted the last 6 years of his motion picture development expertise exclusively to pushing the Easy Rider franchise. Obviously, this article is old. It says, I'm sure the Citizen Kane and Casablanca people were all, hey, Phil Pitzer, come continue our saga as well. But Pitzer was exclusively committed to making Easy Rider sequels, with a plural. So,
I don't think it's a thing.
Good nothing?
I'm looking. I mean, I see some things. All right, the script for Easy Rider, The Search Continues, called for scenes using outtakes from the original.
Oh.
Including one of Mr. Hopper and Mr. Fonda buying drugs from a Mexican drug dealer. Mr. Pitzer and his partners in the Malibu Movie Company and Easy Rider New Millennium Productions, fanboy, say that when they bought the rights, they were also buying clips and outtakes from the original that had not been seen before. But after shooting began, they couldn't get their hands on the clips. Making matters worse, they say the film's original producers, Bert Schneider and Rob Raffleson, suddenly told them they had no rights. Now Mr. Pitzer has gone to court to get the project moving again. He and his partners filed a suit in Santa Monica Superior Court against the original producers, claiming fraud and deceit of the sale of the original sequel rights. The suit also maintains that Mr. Pitzer and his partners fear the outtakes have been seriously damaged and are unusable.
So, how old was this article?
All right, this article is 2006.
Yeah, so that's old.
But so I'm wondering if...
So, they did sue each other. Those people in Pitzer did sue, but Pitzer won.
I'm just wondering if The Search Continues was actually the one that was supposed to be, and then The Ride Home was the one after, because this one was 2012. Mm-hmm. So, I'm trying to get my feet under me here. Let's see, there's something in here from 2022. Easy Rider Reboot in the works. Rights holders to update Dennis Hopper Peter Fonda classic. Producers behind the reboot are currently in search of bold writers and directors to update the project for more modern times with the same fringe spirit. Filmmakers use the Michael B. Jordan's Creed and its relationship to the Rocky as a comp for their ambitions.
From using actual drugs on set during shots to hauling heavy equipment everywhere they went, the cast and crew of Easy Rider sure went through a lot to make that production a success, and now Reboot seems to be in the mix. According to Variety, a remake of the legendary film Easy Rider is now in the works, marking the beginning of the new edition of the 1969 film. Reportedly, the Reboot's producers are currently searching for bold writers and directors to help revamp the project. But don't worry, they don't plan to completely change the vibe of the film. Instead, the producers hope to address contemporary issues in a way that mimics how the first Easy Rider did when it was first released. That's not all, though. According to a report, directors are talking about how they plan to manage the reboot in a way that's similar to how the Creed movies relate to the Rocky universe. So it's safe to say the entire thing is going to be very interesting.
Our goal is to build upon the counterculture and freedom narrative the original left us with, and give the youth of today a film that pays serious attention to their own countercultures and challenges. There's no mention of the Pitzer guy. So I believe that it's being shopped without him.
So, remember how I told you at the beginning of this that the movie was released at Tampa Bike Fest? Well, this article says that's not true. Just goes to show you can't trust what's on the internet.
No.
This says that it was in Las Vegas, was the first time that it was played, in some place called Brendan Theaters. The director of this movie says that Easy Rider the Ride Back is a story, wrapped in a story, wrapped in a story, which is probably the most accurate way that I could describe that.
With no end.
That's not necessarily a good thing.
Yeah, it's not what we're shooting for.
So, anyway, that's our second movie that we've done in this little series. Do you all like these? Is this something that we should continue doing? There's tons and tons of movies out there. I think they're interesting. You know, gives us something to talk about. And I mean, anybody like this movie? Let me know in the comments what you think. Best parts, worst parts, whatever.
Is anyone brave enough to admit they like this movie?
I tell you what it did. It made me want to go ride on those roads.
Well, I think one of the things it also does is it makes you want to ride in the desert, like in Arizona.
Yeah, I want to go ride those long, straight roads in the desert. That's what this movie made me want to do. Of course, the first one made me want to do that, too. All right, fellas. Ladies.
And ladies.
Until next time.
Oh, I got a ride.
Until next time, stay free. Keep the shiny side up.